heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And God said, let there be light. And there was light. And God saw the light, that it was good.
It could change physics forever. The revamped Large Hadron Collider, LHC, is due to be restarted after a two-year hiatus. Described in some reports as a monstrous underground atom smasher, the LHC is the world's most powerful particle collider, and it's already revolutionized physics with the discovery of the Higgs boson. Higgs boson's ability to give mass to most elementary particles has earned it the nickname the God Particle. The LHC is expected to run faster than ever and is predicted to reach its highest collision energy by June. It's on course to smash all records and solve some of the biggest mysteries in physics.
After years in the repair shop, the world's most complex machine is coming out of hibernation. Scientists are hitting the restart button on the Large Hadron Collider. Straddling the French-Swiss border, what's been called the Big Bang Machine consists of a 17-mile underground ring. There, subatomic particles travel at almost the speed of light and are smashed together, allowing scientists to sift through the aftermath in an attempt to answer unsolved questions about things like dark matter, supersymmetry, and extra dimensions. The LHC is a science experiment that took decades to come together. The LHC was finally up and running in 2008. For the first time, a beam of protons steered around the collider, but it wasn't a smooth start. 9 days later, an electrical problem damaged the machine. About 1 year and $40 million in repairs later, the machine was back online, and the payoff was colossal. In 2012, CERN announced the discovery of the elusive Higgs boson, the so-called God particle, thought to explain how other particles get their mass. But the following year, the $10 billion proton collider was taken offline for refurbishing. Now, it's being fired up again. This run is due to go through 2017. With the upgrades, particles can collide together at even higher energies, giving scientists another chance to unlock the mysteries of our universe.
The Large Hadron Collider is being fired up this week after a two-year hiatus, and a group of scientists believes that the results could prove the existence of parallel universes. Scientists believe that a second run of the LHC could produce or detect miniature black holes, which they argue could point to entire universes hidden away in higher dimensions folded into our reality. Now the LHC will be powered to its highest ever energy levels, about double those of its last run. And if these scientists are right, the new run could uncover black holes tucked away in dimensions beyond the four that we interact with in our daily lives.
So the book of Revelation opens up the future for us. So in Revelation chapter number 9 and verse 1, the scripture says, "And the fifth angel sounded, and I saw a star fall from heaven unto the earth, and to him was given the key of the bottomless pit. And he opened the bottomless pit, and there arose a smoke out of the pit as the smoke of a great furnace. And the sun and the air were darkened by reason of the smoke of the pit. And there came out of the smoke locusts upon the earth, and unto them was given power as the scorpions of the earth have power. And it was commanded them that they should not hurt the grass of the earth, neither any green thing, neither any tree, but only those men which have not the seal of God in their foreheads. And to them it was given that they should not kill them, but that they should be tormented 5 months, and their torment was as the torment of a scorpion when he striketh a man. And in those days shall men seek death, and shall not find it, and shall desire to die, and death shall flee from them. And the shapes of the locusts were like unto horses prepared to battle, and on their heads were as it were crowns like gold, and their faces were as the faces of men. They had hair as the hair of a woman, and with teeth were as the teeth of lions. And they had breastplates, as it were, breastplates of iron. The sound of their wings was as the sound of chariots of many horses running to battle. And they had tails like unto scorpions, and there were stings in their tail. Their power was to hurt men 5 months. And they had a king over them, which is the angel of the bottomless pit, whose name in the Hebrew is Abaddon, but in the Greek tongue hath his name Apollyon. Woe, one woe is past, and behold, there come two woes more hereafter. Now, what I'm going to preach you this morning may be one of the most important messages that I've ever preached in all the years that I've been preaching the Word of God. But what I have studied has alarmed me greatly to the point to where I need to get this material out to you that are listening. I originally had planned to preach this tonight, but the Holy Spirit changed my mind and said, preach it in the morning. So this morning, I'm going to preach you a message about something that is happening right now. It's in CERN, Switzerland. Now, you may not be aware of what's going on over there, but there's a thing over there that's called a Large Hadron Collider, and it is an accelerator. It accelerates particles and then brings them to the point of collision. So this Large Hadron Collider was started up just a few days ago, and it's still in the initial process of being brought online completely. You say, what in the world does something like that have to do with me and the Bible? It has a lot to do with you and the Bible. It makes an application to your life and to this world as we know it today. For what is happening in that collider is an astounding thing. So I want to read something to you this morning from a theoretical physicist, Stephen Hawking. And he is one that some rate even on the level of Einstein. Listen carefully. These are the words of Stephen Hawking. He recently warned the reactivation in March of CERN's Large Hadron Collider could pose grave dangers to our planet. The ultimate reality, check, we are warned. Hawking has come straight out and said the God particle, and this is what you've heard referred to time and again as the Higgs boson particle, the God particle found by CERN could destroy the universe. Now let that settle in. This man is an atheist, and he says there is no God. Yet he says that what's happening right now in CERN, Switzerland, and I'll give you what they're trying to do in a moment, what's happening at this very minute in CERN, Switzerland, has the potential to destroy the universe. Astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson has also sounded the alarm by telling anyone who might want to blow up a planet how to do so is this CERN's attempt to do so by attempting to recreate the Big Bang within a man-made structure. This has frightened Stephen Hawking so much. Do they know that they know that they know what they are doing? Ask yourself, how much energy is keeping it together? Then you put more than that amount of energy into the object, it will explode. I've quoted two physicists. These are scientists. These men do not agree with what's happening in CERN, Switzerland right now. There is a 17-mile long accelerator that lies 300 feet beneath the surface of the ground. This area is where France and Switzerland come together. So part of this accelerator is located in France and part of it in Switzerland. It is a joint European project. The United States of America is there as an observer, but the brain power that's going in to this experimentation originates in Europe. They are attempting to recreate what they believe happened that brought all of this into existence as being the Big Bang. Now, you and I know from the book of Genesis, chapter number 1, that in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. He spoke it into existence. They are finding things, and this is what's important for us to understand today. They are discovering things that they did not expect to discover as they get deeper and deeper into this experimentation. They are beginning to find out that there is a whole lot more to the creation than they had ever given thought to before. They're beginning to find out that there's something going on here that boggles the human mind, that literally blows us apart when we try to even comprehend what's happening. This 17-mile long underground tube that is located there in Switzerland has, I think, 4 or 5 different points where they collide particles that are being moved at or above the speed of light inside this collider. They're looking for the very building blocks of what brought all of this together. To give you an analogy, let's say you have a house. You observe that house, it's beautiful. You think, my goodness, let's see how this is put together. And so you start taking the house apart and you expect to find nails, but instead you find glue. That fascinates you that much more. Because you find glue holding this house together, you wonder to yourself, what was this glue like before its hardened state? Because you see, once the glue glues the things together, it hardens, solidifies. They want to know what the glue was like in its liquid state. So they're going through this to go back to that point to where they can separate and find out what this was like then. And by doing that, of course, they can build on the information and knowledge that they attain. Now, what's going to follow in the message this morning is the implications of what's going on. But let me give you just a little bit of what has been happening. Where they have done this experimentation, strange things are happening, unexpected by the scientist. Paranormal phenomena, they like to call it. Apparitions, ghosts, all kinds of demonic spirits are beginning to manifest themselves in ways. Here we have, in CERN, Switzerland, a huge wheel. Inside that wheel is a Hindu god, and his name is Shiva. He does a dance of destruction inside that wheel, and his purpose is he is one of the triad gods, one of the greatest gods of Hinduism. Shiva, Vishnu, and Brahma. Brahma is the god of creation. Vishnu is the god of preservation. But Shiva is the god of destruction. The way the Hindu sees it is that when Shiva destroys, it's not for the purpose of annihilation. He destroys so that Brahma can come and recreate. So now when the Hindu sends their scientist to CERN, they put this out there in front. And so what these people are doing with the collider is destroying what comes together, but for the purpose of recreating and find out what brought it into existence to begin with. Are you following me? Yeah. Now here we have men that are scientists on an average of an IQ of anywhere from 160 to 200 or even above. These are some of the smartest brains in all the world. No question about it whatsoever. But we were told when Darwin's theory of evolution came out and became vogue that it would destroy the foundations of Christianity, and this old book that we hold in our hands, this old outdated Bible, would no longer be relevant, and a lot of people bought into it. Because after all, Darwin is scientific. But it's an amazing thing now that 150 years later, we have some of the greatest scientists in the world that are becoming very religious. Because here they've got Shiva, they've got dances to Shiva.
Thank you. works for me.
They are definitely being connected with Shiva as their finding thing. Let me give you one example. In one of their collisions, when they collided these particles together, they saw things. They were apparitions they didn't expect to see. They didn't fit in any model. They didn't fit anywhere. They don't belong, but they could not deny the reality of it. Something was going on inside there that they could not explain. And it was scary for them. For the scientist has his paper and his pencil and his books, and if it doesn't fit in his paper and his pencil and his books, it's out the window. They don't understand. They have a hard time accepting the fact that there is a spirit world out there. That spirit world was created by a spirit being, an almighty, eternal, absolute being that is from everlasting to everlasting, who put in me what I am today by the power of Almighty God and by the power of the new birth. But a scientist like that will never admit that, because that takes it out of his control and his power. Stephen Hawking has warned these people, you are about to open Pandora's box. And once you open Pandora's box, you cannot put back in what came out of that box. The Bible said, he that letteth will let until he be taken out of the way. 2 Thessalonians chapter number 2. God Almighty is going to let them go so far, but he's not going to go any further. Demons, all this other stuff, probably couldn't care less whether you've got matter or antimatter. It's a spirit being. But to fit into the great deception that's coming, and it's coming, and it's about here right now. I mean, a deception like this world has never known before. To fit into this great deception, they can sure draw these men in to make them think that because they have reached this certain point in their scientific analysis, that they're bringing in these spirit beings. It'll make true believers out of them. NASA said just a few days ago that by the year 2020 that we will definitely come in contact with aliens, beings from another planet. Now we're talking about scientists. We're talking about Darwin's crowd. We're talking about the crowd that threw the Bible out and said it's old, archaic, anachronistic. It doesn't belong today. We're talking about that bunch. We're too smart for the Bible. We're scientists. Yet this crowd is saying that in just a few years that they're going to know, that they know that they're going to come in contact with alien beings. I thought to myself, my. Do you boys, have you always known that you've got a certain date set? And what you think is an alien being is really a demon? There are no aliens out there, folks. Forget that stuff, okay? There's nothing out there. You get into the third heaven, you get into the abode of God. There's nothing up there. All these UFOs, spacecraft, flying saucers, all this stuff, that's all demonic. It's real, but it's demonic. I see a great deception beginning to develop. that in their analysis and in their laboratories that they believe in, that they've got their heart and soul tied up in, little things begin to show up, stuff that they can't explain, that sucks them in to begin to understand, well, maybe this is being affected, it's being acted upon by something that we don't understand completely. And this spirit being that comes from out there, that comes down to this world, they accept with open arms because they're willing to put Shiva out there dancing around in the cosmos and destroying and then bringing a new creation in. Here are these wise, smart, brilliant men, and they're willing to believe that there's something more than what can be measured in a microscope and can be put in a petri dish, that there's something going on, and you better believe there is. Now, in the spirit world that I just preached to you about, you can see that. Now, what about the physical world? Let's go back to Hawking for a minute. He said, remember, he's an atheist. He doesn't believe in spirits. He's a dialectical materialist. He believes that what they're liable to do here in CERN, Switzerland, is unleash the gates of hell on this earth. The reason I took you to Revelation is because in the 9th chapter of Revelation, what you just read, is the gate of hell. Revelation chapter number 4 is the door to heaven. When he catches up his saints to meet him in the clouds, we're going through the door into heaven. But he will open the gate of hell on this earth. And according to Revelation chapter number 9, these beings are coming up out of the earth. If you remember when Saul went to the witch of Endor, she said, I saw spirit coming up out of the earth, coming up. What'd she see? She saw demons. Until God brought Samuel back himself personally, the real Samuel, who appeared before Saul and the witch of Endor. What would be a greater ruse than to use their science and their technology to suck them in to accepting some spirit being coming from somewhere up here, some alien, down to this earth, and do it through a collider over here? This is as high a technology, I suppose, you got on this earth. And do it through that and bring it down upon this earth and bring it into people.
If somebody arrived on Earth from another planet and they asked you, what on earth are you doing at CERN, in a sentence, how would you explain it?
In a sentence, I would say what we're trying to do is understand the universe around us as well as we possibly can.
Is that the way you would characterize what's happening at CERN?
That's the hope, of course. And every scientist is like a child that is playing on the throne, as you know. And that's what everybody on the planet is hoping for. So the intention is marvelous. This physics, which no one knows yet in this realm, also contains dangers. And I'm a little concerned about the dangers that are not yet, how should I say, addressed so far. It is a wonderful hope connected to CERN, and there is a danger involved, and the danger has not been disproved.
That seems not normal. I might have opened a dimensional vortex.
Just don't throw anything into it.
Your little wizard stick.
It's called a staff.
Okay, so here's the deal. There's this real bad dude, wears a helmet. He's been tearing rifts between all the Lego worlds.
Wow. I only understood about half of that, but it sounds pretty bad.
And he's got our friends. So we must return to our quest to save them. To the gateway! You shall not be.
Guess we're on wizard time.
I do believe it is now my turn to operate this vehicle.
Well, nice meeting you, whatever your name is.
I still don't entirely trust you.
Many thanks for your assistance, Goodly Giant.
No problem. Good luck.
Storm, we gave you 6 years and millions of dollars, and you gave us nothing. What's different now?
Reed Richards. He knows answers to questions we don't even know to ask yet. This is our chance to learn more about our planet and maybe even save it.
What you've created here is incredible.
They just cracked interdimensional travel.
You opened a door you don't know how to close. You don't know anything about what's coming.
What is coming?
Doom.
With every second that ticks by, the future is running out. What if there was a place, a secret place, where nothing was impossible?
Casey, stop it!
Go away! Did you see the dog? Oh,
cool. I want you to take me there.
Take you where?
Where'd you get this?
Who are you, kid?
What you saw was a place where the best and the brightest people in the world came together to actually change it. We've been looking for someone like you for a very long time.
Why? Did something happen over there? Something bad?
They followed you here?
Who?
Come on! Get in!
There's one way in. They know we're coming, so follow me.
All the people, why me?
He thinks you can fix the future.
You wanted to see Tomorrowland. Here it comes.
Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide.
We've never met before, right?
Follow me. Ready or not, here I come.
It's been called the age of wearable technology.
Amazing things happen when we merge technology with our body.
A historic day in sports as the IBA becomes the...
This is not about technology. This is about right and wrong. This is not about technology. This is about right and wrong.
Survive.
It is by my hand. You arrive. From the ashes of this world!
There has been an awakening. Have you felt it? The dark side.
Wanted to see Tomorrowland. Here it comes.
Honey, I think I might have opened a dimensional vortex.
Can you see the dog?
I want you to take me there.
Take you where? Can you see the dog?
I want you to take me there.
Take you where?
You wanted to see Tomorrowland. Here it comes.
That we know there are not hundreds, not millions, but billions of other solar systems out there. Thanks to the Hubble telescope and what we know about black holes in the universe and all of that, the dimensions of physics are such that I would be quite surprised if in the lifetime of people that are no older than 30 here, we don't discover some form of life in another universe. So I think there are lots of interesting discoveries, biological, on Earth, and other discoveries in the heavens that those of you who are younger will get to see unfold. You'll have all kind of problems with them, but on balance, it'll be a plus. And it'll make life much more interesting.
But you have to remember, our world is made up of matter. The antimatter is what we can't see, what we can't touch, what we can't feel, though we interact with it every day. A lot of people like to think of antimatter as the other dimension, which is the opposite of this dimension. It's an inconceivable place that is hostile inherently. It's not under control, it's very hostile. So there's a physical effect to the spiritual world in antimatter. And often, demonic entities and all these other paranormal things are attracted to antimatter. For every gram of antimatter that's produced, and then it's bought into this world, when they produce it, it attracts things from another dimension coming here. What is CERN going to do? It will allow humanity to produce pounds of antimatter. What's happening, that is the unseen portion of dark matter. And of course you have the angels which govern what that realm can and cannot do. Because everything is balanced, the subject of Lucifer in the spiritual sense, because God gives everything balance. Everything has balance. There is dark, there is light, there is good, there is bad. Everything has balance. CERN has yielded so many results and gave a true definition of paranormal activity. It's beyond me that a lot of people cannot get this through the truth of the word. They can't. Antimatter is being pulled out of nowhere, out of this other dimension, which is nowhere but everywhere. In consequence to that, they found out antimatter has a specific type of energy signature that they can in fact detect. This is how they, is part of the process of pulling it out. Well, as it comes to find out, some of the not so good consequences of this process has to do with the human psyche. With all the experiments they found, they have found out why paranormal activity exists. With CERN, as they begin to collide these protons, dark matter is going to be produced in great numbers, in greater and greater numbers. Not only the matter, but the energy signature is going to also be released into this realm. You know what that's going to cause? It's going to cause the dark energy signature within people to begin to activate more and more. You see, it's going to become difficult for people to stay contained or controlled. In essence, they're going to become violent. They're going to have vivid dreams. The darkness within a person is absolutely going to begin to surface. And this is not theoretical. This is not some theory somebody thought of. This is absolutely 100% quantifiable, and it's happened before. It's going to happen in greater numbers this time. It will take effect.
Now here's one of the things about this. This antimatter is also called dark matter. And dark matter has energy attached to it. And the energy affects people. It affects them. And remember, when you produce antimatter, you got to contain it. Because if you don't contain it, you got to contain it. That's the biggest problem, containing it. Because if you don't contain it, it just goes wild. And they don't know what it's liable to do. Now, folks, go check me out. Go check me out. I want you to. Go check me out this afternoon and see what it says about antimatter. And it'll say, yes, you better contain it. Because you don't know what it's liable to do. But they do know this. From what they've experienced so far, it has an effect on people. Dark matter has an effect on people. It causes some people to go screaming mad. It controls people. It is an enormously powerful thing. It's pulling something out of hell that you don't want any part to do with and turning it loose on mankind. Now, you know, I don't know that. I don't ever been in agreement with an atheist before, but I'm in agreement with this one. I and Mr. Hawking see it the same way. They better leave that stuff alone.
What CERN does, it accelerates particles in that big circle around and around and around and around until they're traveling at just enormous velocity, and then they collide these particles together. And in that moment, it creates a moment that they think is kind of how the Big Bang started the whole universe. That's the whole purpose behind it. However, they also believe that there are parallel realities around us, other dimensions, and there could be other intelligence there. However, there's a reason God put them on the other side of that veil, and you might not want to open the door. And here's the thing. Their own director of CERN has gave interviews to the British press in which he admits that's what they're trying to do. They want to open a door to another dimension. And he said, when we open this door, he said, something might come through it into our reality. Or, he said, we might send something through it into their reality. You can look that up. It's in the British press. Where the CERN was built, this is St. Genis Poeli. That's the name of the township. But in ancient days, it was called Apaleiacum. It was literally a temple to the god Apollo, because they believe that's the gateway to the underworld.
So in Revelation chapter number 9, and they had a king over them, which is the angel of the bottomless pit, whose name in the Hebrew is Abaddon. But in the Greek tongue hath his name Apollyon. Now, let's make sense of it for you right now. This is 2015. The church is dead and asleep. The only crowds you have in this country today are the crowds that are pumped up by rock and rap, and it's all about love, self-love, and positive attitudes, and you know, money and me, myself and I. I'm in love with me. I'm in love with myself, and I'm in love with I. You've got the people to the point to where they can be moved emotionally. Not intellectually, but emotionally. Anything stirs people today. They got crowd mentality. They got mob mentality. Can you imagine something that has created earthquakes? That has made apparitions appear? That you've got scientists warning, don't do this? You don't know what you're going to unleash? Maybe there's a greater purpose in all of that that they're not even aware of. He's called Satan. Maybe he intends to bring chaos on this earth. Chaos. Order out of chaos. The peacemaker shows up. The earth is in a turmoil and it's blazing and burning. And then the peacemaker shows up. How close could we be to the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ? How close could we be? How close? The church is asleep. But the Lord's coming back. And to hear about something over here that they can produce 1 gram of it has the potential of 4 atomic bombs. Boy, if somebody got a hold of that, you talk about blackmailing a whole nation. And did you know what? They say they're weaponizing it now. And they say now that the nations of the world, although they've joined together over there in Europe with this collider, they've stepped back and thought to themselves, hold on. If this crowd over here gets that, we need that. And there you go. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but I'm going to tell you this morning what I really believe. I really do believe this. I believe that all the peace and prosperity and joy, as far as this world's concerned, that you've enjoyed, enjoy it. Because I don't think things are going to get any better. I believe they're going to get worse. And I believe you're just beginning to see the beginning of it. And I believe that war is soon to come. There's going to come an Armageddon. There's coming an apocalypse. I hope you're ready. I hope you're ready. I hope you are. I hope you're ready to meet the Lord. I hope you're ready. My biggest fear of this place over here is not them blowing up the world. Although, the Lord's going to make the decision about that. Here's what I worry about coming out of that place, is all this spirit deception, using it to deceive people. They connect spirituality and science together. Imagine. What kind of a union that would have. Science and spirituality. Not Christ, but science and spirituality joined together. Man, they've got what they want when that happens. How many of you know the Lord Jesus this morning? Boy, even so, come Lord Jesus. Now, folks, I've only had 3 or 4 days to deal with this. I've gotten some stuff in here that I need to go deeper into and look at a little further, because there's some stuff going on here that literally blows my mind. But what I've given out to you this morning is just skimming the surface about what's happening in CERN, Switzerland. Some of you may know a whole lot more about some of this stuff than I do. But if you do, you should be alarmed, because of what I've told you, the truth. Folks, this is not hypothetical. If I understand correctly, no more than a handful of matter was used to blow up Hiroshima and Nagasaki. They released the potential in that and blew it up, if I understand it correctly. And that 1 gram of antimatter is 4 times more powerful than what blew up Nagasaki and Hiroshima. You don't want that in the hands of the wrong person. Father, in Jesus' name, I ask you to use what I've said, Lord, for the glory of God. There may be somebody sitting in this house this morning that's awake now. They've wakened up. They're alarmed and they're worried and they're thinking, my goodness, if half of what that preacher said is true, that's enough to stir me. I'm going to do something about it. In Jesus' name and for Jesus' sake.
Amen. So the intention is marvelous. This physics, which no one knows yet in this realm, also contains dangers. And I'm a little concerned about the dangers that are not yet, how should I say, addressed so far.
We have the power to overcome our own flesh, because the darkness in this world is about to be pulled out of everything. Everything with darkness in it, that darkness is about to surface in a way that no one ever forecasted or thought possible, but it's absolutely going to take place.
Are you watching this, guys? Are they watching this?
This is one of our darkest days as a city.
And the only way a person can overcome this is through the true power of the Holy Spirit. And to stay within the blood of the Lamb, there is no hypocrisy in purity. There is no hatred in purity. There is no accusation in purity. And people need to be in that purity in truth, not acting like they're in the purity. They have to be there. It has to be in their hearts. And they have to do everything they can do right now so they can be strong enough to endure. None of us knows when we're absolutely going, but I, for one, intend to finish this race, and I'm trying to sound an alarm that something very different is going to be all too evident to everybody who believes in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And without Him in truth, they're not going to make it. They will not make it without Him in truth.
One of the tragedies of Nepal's earthquake is that many of the country's most treasured cultural monuments were destroyed in the blink of an eye. I'm standing in what was the Fashi Dega Temple. It was dedicated to Shiva, the Hindu god of destruction, and now there's very little of it left.
Update here on the GridX drill that is to take place this month in the United States, dealing with an attack or a blow to the power grid. Now, this was put out months ago. I've covered this on a couple of different occasions, and the time has come for when this whole simulation is supposed to go down. Now, the reason there's so much concern about this is because every false flag event that has ever taken place has coincided with the drill. And this kind of situation would be grandiose. It would be much larger than anything. It'd be 9/11 on steroids. Gridx2 registration.
It's all about the wormhole. It's all about the opening of a hole that leads to somewhere. And I have a strong notion that CERN scientists know where that hole goes. The wormhole. Wormhole technology, told over and over and over in a variety of stories, told as a tale to children and adults alike, from Pan's Labyrinth to Alice in Wonderland. From the Lord of the Rings to Doctor Who. From Farscape to Blue Exorcist to CERN Symmetry. From The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe to Tomorrowland Music Festival. Stories from all over the world, some of them hundreds of years old to ancient. They tell of the same legend. A character approaches a door. Someone crawls through a tunnel. They might fall into a hole. They might step foot into the other side. All of these tell the story. They sing a song. They dance a dance. Because an ancient knowledge has been preserved, passed down for millennia. It's been retold in books, placed into cartoons for children. It's been built into the architecture of churches. It's been shown in the walls and ceilings of epic buildings. It has been the central subject of video games. One retelling of the wormhole is found in an extremely popular manga anime called Blue Exorcist. Blue Exorcist has set records for sales in Japan and has become very popular to Western audiences. Blue Exorcist is an ongoing saga running since 2009 as a manga and appears to be popular with both teens and young adults. But the themes in it are anything but childish. The manga anime depicts hybridity, transhumanism, CERN doors and dimensional rifts, Gehenna, a demonic invasion, dark matter, the Illuminati, and speaks extensively about a false war coming between Satan and a Messiah. Of course, this Messiah is not Jesus Christ, but the Antichrist. The basic premise surrounds two boys, born as hybrid creatures, appearing as human and yet they are part fallen angel. These two fight against Satan and have to defend the human realm against a demonic invasion, though ironically they are part fallen angel and fallen angel blood runs inside of their veins. The war depicted in Blue Exorcist is between another dimension and the human realm. The basic premise of this war is a false construct in which individuals from the other race are fighting on behalf of humanity. In the series, Satan has the idea to open a gate known as Gehenna Gate. This gate would connect the world of Gehenna, which is an abyss, and Asaya, which is the normal human world. This is the same gate that has been shown over and over and over, a gate connecting the realm of humanity with another realm. In the manga, Satan is trying to open the Gehenna Gate so that the world will be swallowed into the bottomless pit, the abyss. You'll notice that the show depicts Gehenna Gate as a large, dark circle that looks suspiciously like a black hole with a door on it. On the door is an upside-down cross. Demonic entities are hurled out of this gate and towards the earth. Some of these demonic entities look like dark particles, as you can see here in the images, and they manifest on Earth. Keep in mind this manga was written back in 2009 through 2010, before much of CERN's agenda was being covered. The characters eventually find out that the door is something called a dimensional rift. A dimensional rift is a portal, or a wormhole, that allows someone to travel through dimensions, overcoming the constraints of time and space. In another famous example, a dimensional rift would even take Dorothy somewhere over the rainbow to another dimension.
Their magic must be very powerful, or she wouldn't want them so badly.
Come out, wherever you are, and meet the young lady who fell from a star, who fell from a star. She fell from the sky, she fell very far.
Not unsurprisingly, we also see the idea of a dimensional rift prominently portrayed in the CERN Symmetry trailer through images showing speeds of acceleration beyond that of the speed of light. How interesting that now CERN scientists are admitting that dimensional rifts or wormholes are their chief ambition. It's only been recently that the search for black holes has been made known to the public, and that they were attempting to confirm a theory called Gravity's Rainbow. In the Blue Exorcist anime manga series, we see references to a false Hegelian dialectic in which two sides are set up, one controlled by evil seeking to unite Gehenna with the real world, and another side controlled by the good, which seeks to bring about their Messiah. In fact, the characters representing the side of good actually comment that they are using the Gehenna Gate to usher in their Messiah. This wouldn't be the true Messiah, but a false Christ and an Antichrist. In Blue Exorcist, the dream for both the side of good and evil is to create a new world order. Satan is the universal bad guy who is trying to open up Gehenna and the good guys are working to bring about their false messiah, and they are allowing Gehenna Gate to be opened so that their false messiah can be ushered in. Literally, the group depicted in the manga as working in stealth behind the scenes to open the Gehenna Gate is named the Illuminati. Their dream is to connect the realms of Gehenna and Asaya. According to this manga, it is the Illuminati who is responsible for building a machine that will mimic the opening of Gehenna Gate. The demonic war against humanity is depicted as coming out of the Gehenna Gate. If you don't know, Gehenna or Gehinnom means Valley of Hinnom, and is a place where the Israelites sacrifice their children to the gods, specifically the gods Moloch and Baal. This valley lies in close proximity to the Temple Mount. Joshua 18:16 and Joshua 15:8 link the Valley of Hinnom with the Valley of Giants, and seem to allude to the fact that Gehenna might be a part of the Valley of Giants. Joshua actually names some of the giants in his book. They dwelt in Ashtaroth, according to Joshua 12:4. Is it any surprise that Blue Exorcist has named one of their characters, a hideous Nephilim, Ashtaroth, who resides in Gehenna? The gate also requires a blood sacrifice in order to be opened. This is the same narrative we see in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 19, where the inhabitants of Jerusalem were condemned for sacrificing the blood of innocents or children to Baal at Gehinnom. Blue Exorcist is yet another retelling of the technology that has been passed down through the illuminated generations, the same technology that has been illustrated in the architecture and design of some of the greatest marvels known to man, and has been shown repeatedly in movies, music videos, television shows, and the likes. We are watching the unfolding of an ancient technology, an ancient ambition that is being achieved only now.